So the one time that I want to be wrong, I get proven right, and that's not really a good thing to many different people, including myself. So, with that being said, they won. Disney won the rights to Bleach. Let's get into it. Now, before you start commenting on this video about doom posting, about all the negatives that you can probably think from the top of your head, please watch the entire video because we will deep dive into those comments that you specifically gave in the last video, even though I already kind of, you know, answered those questions in that video in the first place. So please listen to this video and we'll talk about where we are currently and what's going to happen and why this has potentially happened. Now, of course, if you guys don't know, nothing is going to be affecting it in the Japanese market. This is strictly on the international front, being worldwide. And of course, Viz are the ones that own that license to distribute everything to the worldwide masses. However, Viz doesn't have a video online service, so those have to go to a bidding war against either Crunchyroll or Netflix or Amazon Prime or even Disney in this case. And that's how this kind of works. And just because Sony owns Aniplex doesn't mean that they get first priority. Because if that was the case, then they wouldn't have to go to Viz to ask for the video streaming rights now, would it? So what we know so far is that Disney has bought the rights to all of Bleach's catalog, which again is a good thing in this case scenario. In this worst case scenario, this is one of the best things. And I keep saying worst case scenario because of multiple reasons. One, this could turn out to be a massively good thing, or it can go downhill very quickly. So let's talk about these conditions. One, they have the full catalog. So far, so good. We're probably going to get news in September for the Disney Expo, because as of right now, they are leaks, and pretty reputable leaks at that. In fact, at this point, I'm 100% confident, because as I said, they've bought 100% of Bleach's catalog and the online streaming service to stream Bleach itself. But let's critique this for a second. Let's literally just play devil's advocate on all of this before I go off on a massive rant. Let's say Crunchyroll does have Bleach. You've had Anime Expo, Anime Japan, and quite recently, the Crunchyroll Expo that have just happened within the span of 2 months, and not a single peep has been mentioned. Well, we know where My Hero is getting streamed, we know where Mob Psycho is getting streamed, we know where Chainsaw Man's getting streamed, and Chainsaw Man is Crunchyroll's bread and butter for this season, apparently, and we don't know where Bleach is being streamed. We're 2 months away, literally coming close to September now. Coming close, not there yet, not quite there yet, halfway there. We're coming close to September, and not an utter of where Bleach is going to be streamed, nor has it had the push from Crunchyroll. Let's say Crunchyroll does have the license to Bleach. What poor, mismanaged marketing are they playing at? So either way, we don't win in this situation, whether they have it or not. The marketing's been terrible. But if I had to find a silver lining in all of this, what is good about Disney and why? I mean, besides my own personal bias against Crunchyroll, because they are just, what are they? They are a shell of their former self, and they're just monopolizing everything, wasting money on buying out Crunchyroll Originals, buying every anime company out there in the West. Recently, they just bought out Right Stuff and then started dictating what Right Stuff could and couldn't sell. It's a complete buyout of every company in the UK, in Europe, in the US, and now even in the distributing factor. So, you know, Crunchyroll is just too busy wasting its money, taking away the competition, and it's borderline monopoly. I'm surprised they haven't been sued yet. Maybe if they stop wasting money on buying things such as High Guardian Spice and buying out every company, maybe they would have had enough money to buy Bleach. But I digress, they don't have the money. And why I said that they don't have the money, and people keep, oh well, Sony's the one that owns Crunchyroll, of course Sony's got the money. No, they don't. And it's a specific reason of, at the end of the day, Crunchyroll is a sister company to Sony. They get an annual budget, or even a seasonal budget of what they can spend. So, you know, chances are they've already spent that budget. It's not like Sony's going to hand over more money unless it, like, makes investment sense, such as buying out companies, I guess. But still, they have a budget and they've probably over-exceeded it, especially with Chainsaw Man. Because I would imagine MAPPA have asked quite a lot for Chainsaw Man, considering that they are their own production committee. Anyway, without getting into that, what are the goods and bads of Disney in all of this? One, Disney has now, as of a few days ago, been announced to be the biggest streaming platform in the world. Like, it overtook Netflix quite recently, I think yesterday or 2 days ago. It overtook Netflix in subscribers, and it is on a very good high trajectory. That, in this case, is good. And even though I don't like Disney all that much, in this case scenario, it's not that bad of a thing. So there's that, and I also believe that Disney would market it way better than Crunchyroll ever would have, seeing as they've got their penis so far up Chainsaw Man's ass right now. In marketing, you always use the 10% rule, being that if Disney has 140, 150 million subscribers, you take 10% of that as active people that just watch Disney Plus all day, every day, right? Diehard Disney Plus fans. If you take 10% of that as maybe anime watchers or people that are watching anime on the platform, then you probably have a good idea of how many people are potentially going to be watching that show, give or take. You're kind of lowballing by 10% and then 10% in that 10%. And you can do the same with Crunchyroll, because people are there to watch certain shows. Not everyone's going to be watching certain shows of that category. Now, yes, Crunchyroll does have like 120 million active users on the site, but only a few million. No more than maybe 10, no more than maybe 15, at most, at a high reach. 10% that of people who are going to watch your My Heroes and your Chainsaw Man's. And then maybe even 10% that for specifically Bleach. Even the highest 10% is not making up for Disney Plus's 10% of a 10%. And that's what I mean, is that still, there's going to be more eyes on Bleach on Disney than I believe on Crunchyroll. And that is my belief system of how I'm kind of rationalizing it. Granted, Crunchyroll is the main streaming platform for anime, but because they're so overly diluted and because not many people have probably watched Bleach that have subscribed to Crunchyroll over the years because of how much of the new generation are watching it, chances are maybe it would have had a better chance on Disney Plus. And considering the numbers in that regard and considering the advertisement, I believe Bleach maybe would have thrived better on Disney Plus, only on one condition, and this is on Viz. That condition being that Bleach needs to be simulcasted. It needs to be airing on a weekly basis, an hour after the Japanese release, or maybe even at the same time, who knows. If it fails to do that one simple thing, you can see Bleach not being on the map whatsoever. And that's the only problem. If Disney simulcast Bleach, I think actually will be quite fine. I think that that's maybe not such a bad idea, and I might actually support that a lot. Now, granted, I would prefer Crunchyroll. I don't like Crunchyroll at all. I think they're a bad company. However, considering I've spent over 10 years supporting this company in the mindset of, they did a video back in 2012, maybe 2014, I can't remember which year it was, they did a video talking about how half the money of the subscribers goes to them and the animation studio that made whatever show you're watching, right? They take all those numbers and they give their share. I was under the influence that that was the case, and that's why I subscribed, to give my money back to Studio Pierrot to get Bleach back on the radar, and that's what I believed. Clearly, that isn't the case. It never was the case, or maybe if it was, it was back in the day, because it certainly isn't the case now. And the unfortunate thing is that after all these 10 years, even though it says 2016 on this screenshot because I changed banks, so, you know, take that as you will, I've spent over 500, definitely easily over 500 on just a subscription alone. That's my investment that I gave into the company that clearly wasted it on Crunchyroll Originals and wasted it on stupid acquisitions of companies that nobody fucking asked for, and clearly they don't care. They seriously don't care. The one thing that made Crunchyroll put them on the map, oh, Sword Art Online put them on the map, maybe, but who put Crunchyroll on the map before that? Who? Because they had two separate apps on the App Store. One was Watch Naruto Online and the other one was Watch Bleach Online. And there were two Crunchyroll symbols. It was the first edition of the app. Those were the two series that really pushed Crunchyroll in the 2010s, 2011s. And to see you not prioritize or even try, I don't know how much money was involved, but the fact that you didn't even get it and you backed out because Disney money was a bit too intimidating for you was pathetic. I'm actually genuinely upset. Like, Crunchyroll's incompetence genuinely knows no bounds. And Viz, they're not off the hook just yet. I'm not going to flame them yet, even though I have done plenty of times. If they don't simulcast this, if Disney don't simulcast, it is the fault of Viz to undeniably not be able to make that in the contract a necessity, because Viz have the ability as the license holder to say, yes, you can have this, but you have to do it on a weekly standard. And if they fail to do that, if Viz fail to put those conditions in place in the contract, in the licensing, then Viz themselves have also fumbled. And Viz themselves clearly don't care, and all they cared about was the fat bag that came at the end of it. I'm tired of getting so insulted as a Bleach fan. Not one company can do this damn series correctly. In fact, the Japanese are the only ones doing this series correctly. And that's pathetic. The exhibitions, the new products that we're getting, the promotion in Shonen Jump, the Twitter accounts that are promoting it day by day by day. Meanwhile, the Western companies are just so out of touch with their fandoms and so out of touch with their own IPs that it's genuinely frustrating. That being said, I personally will be cancelling my Crunchyroll subscription and saving my money for once and not give my money to them because they fumbled. And it's upsetting because I was under the belief that they would care, if that makes sense. And if you want to be on the pirate's life and illegally watch your Bleach, you know, it is what it is. If that's what it takes for us to watch it on a weekly basis and get the series out there and trending on Twitter and trending on the internet, then so be it. That is one of the best forms of marketing. And that's on Disney Plus then at that point, if they don't want to simulcast it. Again, they have their own ways of doing things. I can't blame them. People are going to talk about censorship. Oh, is the mouse going to censor Bleach? No, Disney have no part in the production whatsoever. They have bought this IP with the notion of knowing what is going on. They've already bought Summertime Rendering, which is very gory in and of itself. But hey, let's just use a contrarian mindset and say, hey, let's say that they do censor Bleach, which they will not, and I can't fathom that enough, even if they did censor it. You're telling me the live version on the TV Japanese version is going to be censored? Because we already know for a fact that it definitely isn't going to be censored. So if it's censored, it's censored. We're going to see the gory version anyway online in maybe like an hour or two after the TV release anyway. So who cares? Who cares? At this point, it's like just try and consume Bleach as much as you can and just get it out there talking on the internet as much as you can. That's really all you can say. It's a shame that we're at this point. But I'm going to keep my heads up high about it. And I think that Disney, if it can be simulcast, is still one of the best decisions. Its trajectory in active users and subscribers is booming right now in comparison to all the other social platforms. Its player and its interface is way better. And honestly, you are going to reach a larger market. It's on TVs. It's on computers. It's on tablets. Everyone from every age is using Disney Plus. Honestly, this might be a good thing. And also, I do want to put in there as well that the reason why they probably got Bleach, and this is, you know, why they got Summertime Rendering and why they got some other series that Made in Abyss, for example, and they've gotten loads of other, and why they're getting into the anime game in general and building up a catalogue, is I genuinely think Bleach was something that they know from a marketing and business perspective. I generally think that Disney Plus use their anime tab, because they're going to have an anime tab like every streaming service does. I genuinely believe they're going to use Bleach as the marketing headliner for that category. It's going to be the banner picture. And the reason why I say that is because you have older people that are still fans of Bleach. You're going to have younger people that are still fans of Bleach. And when they see that on Disney Plus, people who aren't involved in anime Twitter or anime YouTube or even in the anime scene in general, when they go on Disney Plus and see Bleach on the anime category of Disney Plus, they're going to be invested, and those are the ones that are probably going to be pushing it as well as many of us. So I think that's why they wanted Bleach. They wanted a big name to push their anime catalog. And, you know, if that's what it takes, I'm all for it, because Bleach will move numbers, and Bleach is probably one of the best IPs you can have to push your new series on a TV app or streaming app in general. If you want to get up to date on all the Disney news and the X, Y, and Z, please, there's a Twitter in the description down below. Go follow me over there. And as a reason as well to why, you know, Disney might actually do it in bulk rather than simulcast is because Disney translate like 20 different languages in comparison to like Crunchyroll's like 5 to 4 different languages. So, you know, Disney has a lot more to translate in terms of its wide worldview. And of course, also Disney, is more available worldwide in comparison to Crunchyroll as well. And as well, I will say, because we spoke about cores and split cores before, if anything, Disney going the split core route may actually, if it does do it in bulk, if it does, I don't know about simulcast, but in my head, if it does do it in bulk, it would make sense now, maybe, that Bleach would probably go split core. And if people don't know what split core means, it means doing like 12 episodes, then taking a break, then doing another 12 episodes, and then taking a break, and then another 12, then taking a break, etc., etc. It would make sense because obviously once Bleach has hit like that episode 12 mark, then chances are Disney will release it. And then after a month, probably do another 12. So that kind of would make more sense and probably more suggest the split core thing with the streaming service. So, but That's just something I've got to look into. With that being said, anyway, guys, I'm going to catch you guys. Like you guys, of course, have this fine day, Ben Hansen. And as always, people, peace out.